The Philippine peso again closed at its weakest level of 59 to the US dollar Monday. The last time it closed at that level was on October 3rd. The strengthening of the US dollar has been causing currencies of other countries to depreciate. Analysts have said the Philippine Central Bank needs to keep pace with the US Federal Reserve to keep the peso from weakening even further. The Fed has been on an aggressive policy tightening cycle in a bid to bring inflation in the US back under control. Meanwhile, the Philippine government restarts talks for a loan deal with China to fund some of its major infrastructure projects. Transportation Chief Bautista says the finance department may close the deal by early next year. The loan covers three projects, including the Mindanao Railroad.
The deal with the Chinese is for them to support three projects. One is the Bicol South Long Haul. Another one is Clark to Subic, and the third one is the Mindanao Railway. The availability of the loan expired last June 30, and we have started working with them. So the Department of Finance have initially met with them. We're expecting that we should be able to finalize the loan maybe by early next year, and if that's done by the Department of Finance, we can start again working on the project, because we have already worked on the technical aspect of the project. It's a matter of getting the contractor and finalizing the contract.
Signal number one is raised over several areas in Luzon as a low-pressure area of Aurora develop into a tropical depression. Let's get an update from state weather forecaster Robert Badrina. Good morning, Robert. Go ahead.
Good morning. So the center of a tropical depression, Maymay, was estimated based on our available data 300 kilometers east of Casiguran, Aurora. So that's as of 4 a.m. this morning. So this tropical depression has a maximum sustained winds of up to 45 kilometers per hour near the center and a gustiness of up to 55 kilometers per hour. Presently, or currently, it's moving southwestward at 10 kilometers per hour. So currently, so tropical second wind signal number one is raised in the areas of Isabela, Quirino, Nueva Vizcaya, Aurora, Nueva Ecija, and the extreme northern portion of Quezon, including Polillo Islands. So in these areas, we can expect some rains with gusty winds in the next 36 hours. So expect the areas in the northern Luzon and some areas in central Luzon, because we're expecting that this tropical depression will make a landfall perhaps probably tomorrow evening or early morning of Thursday. So it will cross the areas of central Luzon. So expect generally we can expect cloudy skies with some moderate up to heavy rainfall in those areas. We also raise a gale warning. There's a gale warning particularly in the seaboard of northern Luzon and also in the eastern seaboard of central and southern Luzon. In these areas, we can expect strong to gale force winds, and which may cause some rough to very rough sea conditions. So fishing boats and other small sea crafts are advised not to venture out into the sea, while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves in these areas. So that's the latest on our weather from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center, Robert Badrina. Thank you.
Thank you, Robert.